In this video, we will show you how to use the switch formula. If you find yourself making if statements, trying to figure out if something then that, or if something then that, or if something then that, then the switch formula may be the solution. Here in my database, I have a list of tickets with various possible statuses and types of tickets, so sales question, product feedback, or bug. And the status can be info required, new, or done. We have in progress as well, I believe, in progress here. So in WeWeb, I fetched this collection and I displayed the data as it appears in my database. So in underscore progress, sales underscore question. So not very pretty. In order to format this text, I can use the switch formula. So the switch formula allows me to give an entry point, an expression. For example, I can say, take this information, the status and progress, and then if value one is new, so if the value of this is new, then the result should be new, but with a capital letter. If the value is in progress, then I want you to return in progress, but in a nice format. If the value is done, then I want you to return done, but with a capital letter. And if the value is info underscore required, then I want you to return info required. So now, instead of displaying the information, the status of the ticket, like we have it here in our database, thanks to the switch statement, we're able to say, you know what, if it's in underscore progress, I want you to display in progress with a nice capital letter at the beginning. We can do the same for the type of tickets. We can type in switch and open and close the formula. And it works the same again. So we're looking for a value. And if the expression, so if the type matches that value, then we define the result. So here we have sales question. And here we go. We have bug, and we want to display bug in this case. And we have product underscore feedback as a value in our database, which we want to display as product feedback. There we go. Much nicer in progress, info required, new, done, sales question, bug, product feedback. That's it. That's how you use the switch formula in WeWeb. I'm sure you'll find lots of other use cases depending on your projects. The idea is, if you catch yourself writing complicated if statements, if formulas, look into the switch formula to make sure there's not an easier way to do what you're trying to do.